Hey guys, Coach Sue and Coach Alex here with Physique Development. And in this video, I'm gonna be going over the front delt raise. Now you might also hear it referred to as an anterior delt. When we're looking at the delt as a whole, we have the anterior or the front delt, the medial delt, and the rear delt. And with this video, I really wanted to talk a little bit about some posts I've been seeing about how you shouldn't train your front delt or you don't need to because you get enough volume with pressing movements. And while you do get volume in pressing movements, I think it's also really important to think about how the path for each muscle works and working in that path and not just in a secondary way. So when we're looking at it, we want to look at the origin and insertion of that muscle. So with the front delt, it actually originates on your clavicle here and it inserts here on your humerus. So it's actually going to be more of an angular path, which is something I see done where people raise straight in front of them, where it's going to be a little bit more of an angular path. So Alex, if you could go ahead and show what that angular path looks like. So right here, he's going to be working his front delt. He does a great job with this movement. There is some slight pronation here to get fully short in the front, but it's a great, great movement here. And another way to think about how to get this angle is if you think about when you're rear delt rowing, you'll just straighten your arms and do that same conversely for the front delt. So that is the front delt raise, and it can be used with dumbbells or cables, but it's a great movement to work in that path. Thanks so much for watching. If you have any other questions or want to check out any other videos, give us a look at physiquedevelopment.com.